Hey everyone, my name is Colio Dan, and today I would like to talk with you on something really, really important, and it is why you became a coach in first place. Really, what was the reason, what was the switching moment where you realize that your life purpose is becoming a coach, healer, teacher, and help other people learn the skills you get throughout your life experience? And this is a really difficult and crucial question, which is different for everybody. Some people understood they want to be a coach, coaches earlier, even before they graduated. Other people have multiple careers, multiple things in life, and only then later in life, they realize that they have a passion, that they have something inside their heart, something that they want to share with everyone, that they want to teach and help other people improve their lives. So it is not something that we all embrace and understood right from the beginning. Of course, I also had a quite remarkable journey coming to this step in my life to realize that I really want to help other coaches and consultants and people from all over the world to get their message out there, to be heard, to be understood, and to be able to really get impact to the lives of thousands of people. So this is something that everyone of us, maybe you asked yourself already, maybe you should ask yourself why and when you realized that you have bigger purpose than just living your life. You have bigger purpose than just supporting your family, or bigger purpose than just become a nice person, earn decent salary, live, enjoy, then retire, and that's it. For all of us who are here, all of us who love to teach other people, we know that we have a purpose in life. And this purpose is condensed into something that is really, really powerful. And this is actually the way we teach, the way we feel, and the way we live. So let's start with the simple realization that the most important element, the most important thing in life is helping other people. Most of us can realize this through a kind of self-transformation journey, to a kind of a process where we really find our purpose. But many people didn't understand this simple element of life before they hit a wall, or before they had a really hard time coping with their reality. In practice, what you experience in life is exactly what you want to experience. Maybe this seems a little bit counterintuitive, because of course there are a lot of outside things that are happening to us all over again. There is a rain outside, which is raining. It's not a good time for running at the moment. There is something happening on the other side of the globe, which influence the global politic, which influence where you can go right now. We cannot go to all of the countries worldwide because there is a COVID pandemic. There are strict rules where we can go, what we can do, and other things. But realizing that these outside things are only minor, minuscule, maybe less than a 0.1% influence on ourself, on our close to us reality, is probably the most important realization I've ever had. And I had this realization probably a few years ago. I can't remember exactly when I did this, but I realized that the weather, the politics, the rules in the society, the language, the money, the goals that other people have for you are not, literally not important at all compared to what is inside your mind, inside your soul, inside you. And by realizing this, I actually realized that I'm free to choose what exactly to think, what exactly to believe, and how exactly to empower my actions to make the world a better place for me, for my close people around me, and for everyone I'm working with. For example, if you are working in a big organization, you can influence all your colleagues, all the people around you. If you are a coach or a person who helps other people, you can bring a lot of good vibes, good energy into the conversations, then into the lives of your clients, just by simply switching your mind, by simply changing your attitude, your perception of what reality is. And this is how you can hack and transform the reality by switching your mindset first. And let's get down deeper into this transformation and see what is the number one rule of improving your life and growing personally to the new levels which you never believed you are capable of. So the first rule of this change is actually to embrace that the transformation is something important, that this is vital for your personal growth. This is vital to getting better results for the people in your circle, for yourself, for your loved ones, for your friends, and for all your clients and all the people around you. And by this, you are changing the world. You are not changing the world by immersing into the news feed of the global media. You are changing the world by making these little changes in your circle and then growing and growing and growing your circle in a way that you start influencing more and more people. So this is the way you increase the rate of your self-evolution, the way your mind is evolving to new states. You embrace the transformation as the normal state of being. You will never be in, you will always move. You will never stay still. You have to understand that the transformation is the most natural way of how living matter works. And let me give you this metaphor. Like the butterfly starts from one state, then to other state, and only the third state is the beautiful creature we see flying in the sky, but you have multiple wave of transformation. So if your mind is tricking you and saying you, I'm not worthy enough, I don't know enough, I have no practice, I don't know the language. Many people from all over the world think that they are not worthy of starting and growing their YouTube channel, their coaching business, just because they don't know the language. But you don't know the language right now. When I was a schoolboy, I had terrible English teachers. Most of them were not good enough to make us speak freely English. And I never learned in school English enough to be able to speak. And I self-learned and self-developed my English speaking skills just by practice. And maybe if you are from an English speaking country, you feel that my English is not perfect, but this is not stopping me of doing these kind of videos. It's not stopping me of sharing my message and speaking with a loud voice, even if I perfectly know that my English is not quite perfect. So, first of all, you embrace the transformation. Then you start practicing your identity shifting. And this becomes your outcome-driven process. You constantly change your identity. Nobody is born with their identity in life. And I have to clearly say that 10 years ago, my identity was totally different. 15 years ago, nothing compared to what I am now. If I kept a recording of my first two, three public speeches, first two presentations in the face of my colleagues at the university, and then in my science institutions when I were a PhD student, maybe the first 10 public speaking I have were terrible, actually worse than terrible. And I was not ashamed by them, because really I had this feeling that I want to be capable of doing public speeches. I want to be able to share my knowledge, my expertise, my experience. But I didn't know exactly how to do it. I never get a public speaking classes before I started practicing. I never learned from somebody who is more experienced than me. All my colleagues, yes, they were teachers and they know some stuff, but nobody of them give me some tips. Nobody, actually, even my parents didn't give me tips on how to present in front of audience. And everything I learned from practice, and over again, I constantly shift my identity. I believed that I can't give to the world anything else than science. My whole childhood life, I believed that the only thing I am capable of doing is being a scientist, discover new things, and then be shy, be calm, and trying to present these stuffs and hoping, praying that somebody maybe on the other side of the planet will read my papers and will see that I'm a good scientist. Later on, I realized that there are other ways you can change the world, other ways you can impact the lives of people all around the globe. I discovered that my passion for web technologies, for global connections, is something that I really can implement into my business, and finding the right people that I want to help and then really support them throughout their journey and help them get results into their businesses. I discover what business is not by learning anywhere, but just by simple life experience. So these are all identity shifting that happened over time. And of course, it happened for me quite slowly. It was slow, painful, step by step, two steps forward, one step backward process of generating this, manifesting this shift. But for you, it's not necessary to be that difficult. Of course, it's important because when we grew up older, we need painful moments in order to shift and to move forward. But if you are very highly dedicated and committed, and you already experienced hard moments in your life, if you already went through these struggles in life, you don't need to continue struggling. You don't need to continue feeling these difficult emotions. You can accelerate your transformations by allowing someone to help you and guide you. And this is where real coaching came. People who have experience, who know and practice multiple times, who have the mastery of some area of life, can come into your life, teach you and help you, and contract the time span of your learning process, condense the information you need to empower your mind to shift to a new state. So I know that if you are a coach or teacher, you know this very well. I'm not supposed to show you this truth, because you know it from your personal experience very, very well. But I'm here to tell you that even if you are capable of transforming other people's lives, you are still capable of shifting your own identity into the right directions and improve your personal growth evolution speed by allowing other people to teach you, by allowing other brilliant minds to enter into your circle and to give you their experience firsthand, to teach you, no matter if it is personal one-on-one training, or you just plug into their group coaching programs, or if you just ask them questions over the messenger app. Doesn't matter, but if you allow other highly educated and experienced coaches to enter into your world, you can highly accelerate your reality and accelerate your business growth. And yeah, now let's see the rule number two of your personal growth journey. And this is actually the realization that it is not about your life. It is not about how you will feel the next morning, the next day, how your life will look like the next day. Will you have the dream house or the dream apartment or the dream partner? Will you have the dream business? It is not about all these things which society, online advertising, everyone is trying to tell you. And I have to personally admit that it is quite easy to fall into this trap. Very easy to start believing that personal growth, business growth, personal development, it's all about you. Feeling better, having more material things, having better experiences, having more travels, more enjoyable life. But it is not. This is not the purpose. The mastery of your life is not the end goal of your life. You are not put in place into this same moment in this universe just to feel better. You are not here just to improve your personal situations, to get more money in the bank, to get more stuff, or to visit more touristic places. You are here to help others. And when you realize this, you understand that there is something much, much more stronger than your personal situation, something much more important than what your personal financial situation, your personal feeling, your emotional life is. There is something more important. Of course, all of the things that are happening in your life are important in a sense that they help you get these emotions and then transform them to your mindset and share them with other people. But the end goal, the end game, is helping other people experience the same experiences that you get, helping other people to get the inspiration to chase their dreams or to find their purpose in life. Because the truth is, a lot of people, maybe half of the people or even more, don't have true purpose in what they want to achieve with their lives. And most of the people fell into these traps of believing that their goal in life is just living better. I believe that a lot of people truly believe that this is the end goal. And it is not. And you also know it is not the end goal. The end goal is really making a big impact on the lives of others, and in positive way, not in negative way, because you always, always impact other people's life. And if you don't do it right, you impact negatively the lives of other people. If you don't do anything, if you just stay confined into your personal reality, doesn't matter if it's physical or just mental, you again impact negatively other people. The only way you will deliver what you are supposed to deliver into this universe, and the only way you can positively impact many other people's lives, if you do it intentionally, if you do it with a purpose, if you know what's your purpose in life, if you know what's your goal, if you know what is the meaning of your personal development, the meaning of your personal growth. And this meaning, it's not about you. It's not just how you will feel. The feeling is the easier part. And I will share with you exactly why it is the easier part. The more difficult part is how to share in the proper manner these feelings in order to really make other people touch, sense, and feel what you are feeling, to understand your processes, but not only understand, but also to embrace them and to incorporate them into their belief system for the better. So, with that said, yes, I want to again emphasize that the rule number two of personal growth is understanding on very, very inner level that your purpose is not about you, but rather about everyone else you touch with your voice. So, with that said, let's move to the rule number three of the personal growth. And the rule number three is that the more lofty, the more ambitious goal you have, the bigger blessing you have from the universe and the bigger emotional satisfaction you get from the universe. So if you don't chase a big lofty dream, a big lofty goal, you are making disservice to the universe where you are living. Why? Because even if it looks not really true, but simple goals like purchasing a car or having something material, having a home, having few friends, this is not difficult at all. It's easy. Having something, for example, if your goal is traveling to the most adventurous place on the other side of the world in 1 year, I can truly say that if you set this as the only goal for yourself, you will achieve it in 1 year 100%. There's nothing in the world that can stop you. Even the pandemic, even the money, even anything will be overcome. You will overcome everything and you will reach your goal if your goal is to go to the best place on the other side of the world. And you can do it. There's nothing magical about this, but this is just a simple goal. This is a small little piece of the puzzle of life. And if you don't have the bigger goal, the bigger picture, if you don't know why you are chasing this small piece, if you don't know exactly how this small piece, this small dream fit into the full picture of your bigger goal, you are still doing disservice to yourself and to the universe, because you really do every single step in a purpose. And when you achieve your simple goal, which you may believe it's very hard, for example, my girlfriend didn't know how to ride a bike, and she set this small, in my opinion, but very, very big goal in her opinion. And she said, I will learn to ride a bike in a week. And of course, she don't know how to do it. And it was really painful realization that she had to do it in a week, no matter what. But she achieved it. She actually learned how to ride her bicycle in just 5 days. Nothing more than 5 days. But this is just a small goal in the whole picture of life. If you are just chasing a small goal, even if your small goal is climbing the Mount Everest, for example, which not too many people did this challenge, but if your goal is to climb the Mount Everest or to go to the South Pole, which I believe maybe I will do it someday in my life, then what you will do after you achieve this goal? If it is not part of something bigger, then you are not knowing exactly the directions you are moving. And the biggest goals you have to have in life, the biggest lofty dreams are always about impacting other people. And if you do something for yourself, but knowing that this will bring you the energy, bring you the insights, bring you the experiences that you will share with other people later on, and you will transform this energy into the other people's lives. This is how you really make the purpose of the small things, because every single small thing is part of the bigger picture, and the bigger picture is creating an impact into lives of as many people as you possibly can. And if you are a coach, you know that you are not developing your skills just for yourself. You are developing your skills to help other people. You are climbing Everest to be able to help other people climb their peaks and their mountains. So it's always interconnected, and everything is connected, but not necessarily into kind of spiritual or religious way. I'm not religious at all. I know maybe many of you are religious, and I fully admit and fully understand this, but this is not necessary in order to understand that you are part of a bigger picture, and also your small goals should be part of a bigger picture. Creating an online business is not just a way of making easy money. It's not just a way of living better life with less hard work, less engagement. It is a way to condense your knowledge and share it with more people, which is not possible without this connection we have right now. It's not possible without this worldwide web we are living in. So the rule number 3 of personal development is having lofty big goals, and then have small self-fulfilling goals on the bottom of your list. This way you are layering your goals into 2 distinct categories: the bigger goals, which are on the top of your set of goals, and small self-fulfilling goals, which are at the bottom. But you always know that no matter what happened with your big goals, no matter what happened with your personal life, you will always be able to fulfill the small goals that are necessary fuel to get you alive. For example, eating healthy foods, doing daily exercise, doing running and jogging every other day, climbing the mountains once in a month, getting a nice dinner with your friends or your loved ones. These are small self-fulfilling goals. If you set these goals, if you love doing these things, you will find a way of doing them no matter what. For example, reading a great book. Nothing can stop you from reading a great book in the evenings. So this is small self-fulfilling goal. But when you have a set of such goals, several goals, which you know that no matter what is happening with your life, you will always be capable of fulfilling these goals and fulfilling these emotional needs in your life, you will feel free. You will feel much more relaxed with your bigger goals. You know that it's not 100% necessary to achieve your bigger goals. For example, if you set your goal that I want to teach 1,000 students in 1 year, but you know, even if you fail, even if you teach only 99 students in your first year of coaching, it's still okay, because first, you are on the right track of your bigger goals, and second, you don't need these goals to be fulfilled in order to feel satisfied with your lives. So allowing a 50-50 chance of your bigger goals to happen or to not happen, to be successfully achieved or to miserably fail. If you allow in your mindset that your biggest and most ambitious goals are something that you know in advance that can eventually fail, that can eventually not reach the level that you expected, can develop in something else, and maybe you will once in a while abandon one bigger lofty goal for another goal, because you always transform your state of mind, you always transform your mindset, and sometimes you realize that you switch, that you have another purpose in life, and all of this is totally okay. But you will have more energy to chase these bigger lofty goals, and you will have more chance of achieving more than 50% of them if you are fully satisfied with your basic human needs, and if you very well know what your basic human needs are. And this was, this rule, this realization was the most transformative thing that I ever experienced in life. This really made the difference, because I no longer feel pushy and no longer feel that I have to push my self, to push my myself to such a limit that I will no longer be able to sustain. Of course, I love working 10 hours a day. I love doing incredible progress. I love doing things that nobody believes it's possible. But I'm totally okay if I fail, totally okay if I skip several days of working and just enjoy what I'm doing and recharge my batteries, having few days in the mountain. There's nothing wrong with spending some time for yourself if you know that you are on the right track to achieving bigger, ambitious goals, but you don't chase them to death. You don't chase your ambitious goals as they are the only things that matter in life. You know that you will sustain, you will pass to everything, you will continue to fulfill your basic emotional needs in life, even if you miserably fail in 99% of your ambitious goals. Actually, the truth is, even if you succeed in only one biggest ambitious goal in your entire life, it is still can be worth pushing this adventure. Do you agree with me? Do you really agree with me that you can be fully satisfied with your life if you just achieve only one big, very ambitious goal of 100? Of course you are. Of course you agree that it is possible. So let's summarize. If you want to constantly evolve and grow your state of mind, you have to embrace the transformation. You have to understand that it's not about you, it's always about the people you are impacting in your life. And you have to embrace that you have to be able to chase big ambitious goals and at the same time feel okay and totally fine with the small goals that you have every single day. Chasing big, but satisfied with small. So with that said, you place your mind somewhere in the center of this really big transformational shift, where you know that you have to transform yourself, you have to feel united with the world, feel that you matter for many other people, and that your well-being and your good state of mind is important to motivate and to help other people. And if you are not feeling good, if you are not in a good emotional shape at a given moment in time, it's not just you that you are miserable. It's not just you that you feel bad. It's all other people that can potentially be inspired of you, that are lacking this spark, that are lacking this energy connection when you are not ready and present to give and to deliver. And you always have to want to deliver, no matter what exactly the energy exchange is. Many coaches say that you have to position yourself right from the beginning, that you are exchanging energy only on the highest level. You have high ticket program. You work with the best clients. You work with the top leaders only. But no matter what and no matter who you are helping, it always matters. So it doesn't have to be always this way. You can help somebody who is just starting, who have no money and not enough energy, and you are still in a position to help this person. For example, I don't know who is watching me right now. I don't know what is your situation, where you are coming from, what is your life right now, what are your goals. But if you listen this video up until now, if you get even a small bit of energy, a small piece of spark into your mind from the words I say up until now, then I gave you a transformational experience. I gave it to you absolutely for free. I gave it to you just because I have it in my heart and just because I can say to you that it will be okay, and no matter what you are experiencing at this present moment, you will find a way to move forward. You will find a way to find your goal. You will find the resources and the energy to chase your goal, and you will one day succeed. And you will know that one day when you succeed, you will remember these words. You will remember what I am saying you right now, and you will be in a position to continue forward this path and send this energy for free to other people. So the flow of energy in all the coaching universe is not always on a resonant equal value, equal energy, equal money state. You can be capable of helping every single person you touch and every single person you interact with. Doesn't matter if their situation is enough to resonate with your current state, or if they are a lot more beginner level, a lot more starting type of persons, and they cannot afford your private one-on-one coaching. They cannot afford your group coaching, but they can still get freely from you some inspiration, some experience, some practical tips. This is what I'm giving you right now. Free all my personal experience that I combined from maybe 10 or 15 or 20 years. I can not exactly count how many years I'm on this journey, up until I realize right now at this present moment that I can give this experience from my soul to your soul, and you can get this and inspire other people as well. So thank you very much for watching this video, if you watch it till this end. I'm sure you eventually liked this video, liked my efforts to share these things with the world, and you can click the subscribe and turn the notification bell, and also comment down below where you are right now in your life. What are your goals? How close you are feeling you are to achieving them? What are the obstacles that are stopping you from achieving your goals? I will be very happy and absolutely blessed to answer every single of your comments. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon in the next presentation. Bye-bye.